So, you might have noticed, just hit 1,000 subscribers, which I am absolutely... buzzing about, like, literally have no idea. Anyone that's subscribed, it really does mean the world to me, so thank you very much. Thank you for staying loyal, staying subscribed. Hope you do enjoy the content. So, today's video is top 5 tips for new YouTubers, videographers, making videos, just 5 good tips. The reason I'm doing this is because Easter is next week. I will have been doing YouTube for a full year. That's consistently posting on YouTube. I know I wasn't consistent the whole year, but I have been consistent for most of the year. So I'm just gonna take you through a few tips and a few little lessons that I've learned in the last year. And we're gonna start with tip number 5. 5 being the least important, 1 being the most important. However, they're all very important. Just one is very, very, very important. So, tip number 5 is to ignore the trolls. Do not feed their fire. People love being negative on YouTube. You wanna know why? Because most of the time, when they dislike the videos, don't dislike this one. When they dislike your video, it's anonymous, so no one can ever find out who liked your video or who disliked your video, so people can hide behind that. If you don't have thick skin, do not do YouTube, because no matter what you post, if you're posting good quality content, positive content, people are still gonna hate no matter what. But the tip is just ignore it. Dislikes can't be helped. You can't please everyone, just get that in your head now. And don't get disheartened when people dislike your video, when you get bad comments. I'm sure there is 99.9% of the people are enjoying your content if it's good. So ignore the trolls, ignore the haters, ignore the negativity. You don't need that in your life, so forget about it. Tip number 4. Not very good at doing finger actions, so we'll probably struggle when we get through. Tip number 4 is audio. So when I first started YouTube, I had no idea I was putting Chris Brown, Justin Bieber, all of this behind my videos. And every time I'd post a video, spend so long making it, and it would get taken down from YouTube or no one would be able to watch it. That is because that music is copyrighted by the artist. What you need to do is get either copyright-free music or royalty-free music. Literally, go on YouTube, type in either copyright-free music or royalty-free music. One thing I would do is read through the comments and read in the description. Sometimes there might be a clause. Sometimes you'll find in the comments that people have used that music and they've had a copyright strike. So that's quite disappointing. So it's always good to check that before you go ahead and use the music. Right, so we've had to change positions because the cleaners just came in and got a little bit embarrassed. And obviously I didn't want to film in front of them. So here we are. On the top floor now with some nice late evening sun coming through. Number 3, it's just basic camera skills. So keep a steady hand, try and keep yourself in focus and in frame. So I'll show you what that means. So here we are on this camera here and we're not in focus. So click on me, hopefully, if it's caught out of focus. So there we go, I'm in focus now. You wanna try and set yourself in the middle of the frame during times. Finally, try if possible and keep a steady hand. If you don't have a steady hand, your footage literally looks like this and people get distracted really easily and they won't want to watch it because it's just a melt. No one wants that. So if you don't have a steady hand, set your camera on a tripod like this. That's a gorilla pod, not a tripod. Flexible, bendy, you can do whatever you want with it. Finally, this camera here that I'm filming on, show you on this one. It has a screen to the right, well, to the left. This camera here has a screen on top, which is good because it means when you're looking at it, even if you're looking at yourself in the top to make sure you're in frame, to make sure you're in focus, you will still be able to look like you're looking into the lens. This camera, if I'm talking and looking at myself, it looks like I'm looking straight past the camera and not targeting my audience. So always look into the lens. Rule number 2 is to stay consistent and be consistent. If you want to build an audience, a family, subscribers, a following, you want to be posting on a very consistent basis. So I would say once a week is perfect. You can do better than that. You can do 2 videos a week. You can do 3 videos a week. That's really, really good. But if you want to take it to the next level, Casey Neistat level, you could post daily. Sorry, there's pigeons going crazy out the window. Don't get distracted. So you could post daily. That is gonna build you a good following, a good subscriber base if you're producing good content, but it's a hell of a lot of work, like insane amount of work. Tip number one, the most important tip. Well, that's what I think anyway. And tip number one is to be yourself. So don't try and copy anyone else. Don't try and be someone else in front of the camera. Just be the way you are on a day-to-day basis. And if you have a good personality, you're a nice person, funny, I don't know, you're clever, you're good at giving people information, you're good at helping people, you're good at advising people, just literally be yourself and you will do well. I know for a fact you will. If you're gonna be making YouTube videos on stuff that you're not interested in, you're not gonna enjoy it. So only post content that you enjoy making. Post content that you enjoy videoing, you enjoy filming, you enjoy editing, and you enjoy watching yourself. That is the type of content you wanna be posting. You don't wanna be making videos for other people doing stupid things that you have no interest in whatsoever, because it's just gonna become more of a task. And as soon as it becomes a task, that's when you stop enjoying it, that's when you stop being so passionate about it, and it becomes just nowhere near as fun. YouTube is a hobby for me. I do it in my spare time. It fills my spare time, but I enjoy every single second of it when I'm filming content that I want to film and that I'm gonna enjoy watching afterwards. Hope you enjoyed that video. I hope those 5 tips help you. And if you have any questions at all about anything, comment down below and I'll answer them straight away because I get notifications. And I'm very, very fast at replying. So if you have any questions at all, maybe you don't even want to do YouTube, maybe you just want to make videos for yourself, for Instagram, for Facebook, whatever, comment down below and I'll be able to help you in some way. I've got a year's experience in my belt now, so I'm ready to help. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that.